I'm very honored to share today with you the ICHBB vision of HBV cure. I'm Massimo Levrero. I'm a professor of medicine and pathology at the Lyon University and a member of the ICHBB governing board. These are my disclosures, and this is the overview of what we will talk about today. We will start on why do we need an HBV cure? HBV is a major health problem worldwide with more than 800,000 deaths annually and 257 million carriers. The most important point to remind is that in addition to that, HBV diagnosis and treatment cascade is very poor, with only a minority of patients that access to diagnosis and cure in the world. We have a very ambitious objective set up in 2016 by the WHO. That is to eliminate hepatitis as a public health threat by 2030. This will not be easy. And talking about HBV, we have highly effective drugs, but they reach cure very rarely. And more importantly, they need to be given for a prolonged treatments time. They do not achieve a complete viral suppression, and there is a risk of HCC that is reduced but not eliminated. So having a better cure will overcome obviously the limitation of current treatments, will accelerate the reduction of HBV incidence, and will decrease the risk of hepatocellular carcinoma, will decrease the morbidity and mortality of end-stage liver disease, and will actually reduce the cost of reaching the HBV targets and probably will help to reach it on time. But we have big challenges with respect to HBV cure. The first one is that all immune responses to HBV are quite defective. The liver is immunosuppressive organ, and HBV, the virus, exhausts the immune responses. So we will need to re-educate the liver microenvironment and to train the immune system to clear HBV with vaccine or cytokine drugs, but this will be very hard. The second challenge is the virus itself, the cccDNA, the public enemy number one. The cccDNA is the key molecule of the viral life cycle, is the template for all viral transcript, resides in the nucleus of the infected hepatocytes, organized as a viral mini-chromosome that is transcribed subjected to epigenetic regulatory mechanism, exactly as the host chromosomes. The cccDNA is responsible for the viral persistence, has a long half-life, there is a continuous replenishment of its pool, and is not affected by nodes. We know that cytokine immune signals can affect the cccDNA stability and cccDNA transcription, and so we can consider that the immune control of HBV infection and the so-called epigenetic control of cccDNA functions are, if not the same thing, at least largely overlapping. The third problem is related to Delta. Delta is also persisting as long as the hepatitis B virus persists. And in the case of Delta, there is a very peculiar mechanism. The virus uses the RNA polymerase to work on an RNA template, and this makes difficult to directly target the replicative machinery, because actually it's the host replicative machinery working on the virus. So what we aim for when we talk about HBV cure? There are different level of cures. We have a level that is called functional cure. There are some discussion about the name. It is defined by the loss of HBsAg in the serum, with or without anti-HBs seroconversion, undetectable DNA, that's obvious, but there is still a persistence of low levels of intrahepatic cccDNA that are actually controlled by the immune or epigenetic mechanisms. Functional cure allows for discontinuation of treatments, and HBV reactivation remains possible because the cccDNA is still there and can reactivate. In the case of complete cure, there is a complete clearance of cccDNA from the liver, so there is no reactivation. In the case of sterilizing cure, all integrated HBV sequences in the liver are eliminated, so all trace of virus are eliminated. And again, obviously, there is no reactivation. We always say that the first mechanism is a reasonable objective, the functional cure is a reasonable objective, whereas complete cure or sterilizing cure will be much more difficult to achieve. One important point to remind is that for achieving cure in HBV, we will need to validate the new biomarkers to assess their capability to see target engagement with the new drugs and to predict the treatment endpoints. This is what we need to do with the quantitative HBs, correlated antigen, and in particular with the new biomarker, the circulating HBV, the HBV RNAs. Drug discovery in the field of HBV cure is quite hectic. There is a crowded, dynamic, and very competitive field. We have several drugs with different mechanisms of action. We have drugs that act as direct antivirals, targeting the cccDNA or controlling viral replication. In the case of viral replication, you may target the entry of the virus, the viral transcript, the viral capsid, the viral polymerase, or the release of HBsAg. Some of these approaches also have an indirect immunomodulatory mechanism because they reduce viral proteins that are involved in immune dysfunction. This is just on the left a list of all the drugs that are already in clinical development with their stage of clinical development. In the case of more direct immunomodulatory approaches, you may target the adaptive immunity, or you can target the innate immunity with many mechanisms that I will not have the time to detail. But here again, you have a list of drugs that have been already put into the clinic and tested for their efficacy. Targeting the cccDNA, coming back to the cccDNA, if we want to target the cccDNA, we can aim either to the clearance of the cccDNA, complete cure, or the silencing of the cccDNA, a functional cure. In the case of a complete cure, cccDNA clearance, we can decrease the formation of the cccDNA, we can try to purge the infected hepatocytes from the cccDNA without killing them, using cytokines, genome editing, strategies or those small molecules that destabilize the cccDNA, or we may increase hepatocyte turnover. None of these approaches has already been taken into the clinics. And for all of them, there are questions about the relative efficiency, the duration of the therapy, the safety, and in the case of hepatocyte turnover, you can think that you can very easily understand that you have to be sure of the liver reserve of the patient, because otherwise you can lead to the compensation. Another important point is that this deficiency is not 100%. You lose because the residual cccDNA can reactivate, and there is even the possibility of a generation of a protected or resistant cccDNA pool. In the case of functional cure, We have different drugs that can either inhibit replication, lower the viral antigen burden, or try to re-educate the liver microenvironment and exert an indirect effect on the control of cccDNA. I will now just show you a few examples. I will start with the NOS-targeted drug, the Mirkludex. It's an entry inhibitor. It targets the interaction of the virus with its receptor, the NTCP protein. Is a chemically synthesized lipopeptide derived from the PRIS1 region of the envelope protein of HBV. It inhibits infection of new hepatocytes and HBV spreading. Is active against both HDV and HDV. Is quite well tolerated and is particularly active on HDV. A second example is this time a direct a viral targeting drug, the small interfering RNAs. They target all viral RNAs. In particular, they inhibit viral replication, and they are supposed, but this is still to be proven, to re-enact the immune system by reducing HBsAg levels. There are multiple platforms for delivery, intravenous or subcutaneous. They all use a robust HBsAg level in patients. They have been used with success in experimental models to prime for immune modulators, and they are currently given in patients in combination with other antiviral drugs. Coming to the capsid acid remodulators, there are a vast group of molecules that they are listed. Some of them that are in clinics are listed in the green box. They inhibit viral replication by blocking the formation of a viable RNA nuclear capsid, but they also target the cccDNA because they block the replenishment of the pool and they prevent its formation in newly infected hepatocytes. They are easy to use, mainly daily oral regimens. The combination with nukes increases greatly the potency in patients, but there is a risk of initial response or resistance if given in monotherapy. The side effects are relatively moderate, rashes and AAT flares, but for one molecule, the development has been stopped due to an important flare of transaminases. The last example that I want to make for hepatitis B are an example of immune-stimulated drug, the TLR8 agonist. The leading compound, the GS9688, is already in phase 2. They stimulate innate and adaptive immune cells, and they also turn on the cell defenses against the viruses, in particular in NF-kappa-B and IRF5 and 7 factors, that both are able to block HBV replication. I just will mention a few words on the Delta. We have drugs that target both Delta and the B virus, like Miraculix or the NAPS that I didn't discuss. They are drugs that block the decrease the levels of enveloped viral particles, HBsAg. But we also have drugs that directly target the Delta by blocking the prenylation of the Delta. Large delta antigen. We have no drugs that target directly the delta ribonucleoprotein in the nucleus, but very recently we found that using BAS2B bromodomain inhibitors, BAS2B is part of a chromatin remodeling complex that is recruited on the delta ribonucleoprotein. By using these inhibitors, we can reduce HDV replication by 2 logs. This is not yet in the clinic. A long way to become a drug, but just to say that there is quite interest on new mechanism also for the Delta. Cure for hepatitis B will need combination of different classes of drug for HBV suppression, viral protein depletion, immune modulation. We don't know whether we will need all the three classes, whether we can have more than one molecule from one class, or even more molecules of the same family. Actually, we will have to mix, match, and watch and see the results, because we have nothing that will really tell us what is the best strategy. Can we cure hepatitis B without a direct immune stimulation? This is a big question. Everybody says that we need immune stimulation, but in principle, we can even have a functional cure, if cccDNA half-life is shorter than presumed using some drugs, or if lowering HBs is sufficient to restore enough immune responses. In any case, the cure will be long, more than 1 year, and we'll need very safe drugs. Finally, I want just to present you IceHBV, because I'm talking on behalf of IceHBV today. And IceHBV is the International Commission to Eliminate HBV, was formed in 2016 to aim to a fast-track discovery of a cure that will benefit all people with chronic hepatitis B, and to help towards the goal of elimination of chronic hepatitis B as a global public health challenge as set up by the WHO. ICE is made up of scientists, healthcare personnel, people living with HBV, community representatives, research agencies, global health organization, foundation, pharma industry. You can learn more about ICE HBV by going to the website www.icehbv.org. Thank you for your attention.